Our friends at Discover Newport have brought us Chef Rizwan Ahmed from Hourglass Brasserie, bringing pavé of Parmesan and curry-crusted halibut. Good morning.
Good morning.
It's nice to see you again. It's been a while since you've been here.
Shows, but it's been a while.
It's been a while, but it's good to have you here. We're talking fashion, but you are talking food, and you've got some great stuff for us today. Let's go over the ingredients.
Now, what we're doing today, actually, this is we got nominated to do the Great American Seafood Cook-Off in Louisiana,
which is a great honor for you as a chef, right?
Governor Chafee called me up and asked me if I want to represent Rhode Island, and I said, obviously, I couldn't say no.
Absolutely.
So, but we're doing a dish that actually is most of it's the same dish that we did in Louisiana. I just changed the fish. Mm-hmm. So instead of doing pollock, I'm doing halibut. So people, I mean, can readily buy halibut out here in Rhode Island.
Right.
Pollock's tough to find, but it's more sustainable.
Okay.
But out here we got a pavé. Pavé means rectangle in French.
Okay.
So pavé of halibut, and we're doing a curry and Parmesan crust, which is a little crumbles. We're doing a caramelized point jus, that's squid, again local.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're pairing it off with some pickled cauliflower, some bordelaise sauce, and bone marrow powder. So it's the theme of the dish basically is the past, the present, and the future of cuisine, and how all three can work together on a plate and be a perfect dish.
We know our seafood here in Rhode Island, but I'm sure people down in Louisiana, they love their seafood
they
too.
They love this.
So when you go down
shrimp
there,
shrimp and grits. That's what it was.
Was there a little pressure of like, I've got to razzle dazzle, I got to impress?
There was, but then you know what? Rhode Island has the most coastline out of all the states,
right?
So we do have a lot of variety of seafood. So we went with that confidence that you know what, we do know what we're doing. Even though Louisiana is known for the cuisine,
sure,
and the seafood, and it was a little intimidating with the loss. The judges were southern, the commentators were southern. So they're putting pressure on the northern states, and we could tell it's a little biased. We knew that maybe if it does, a wind does come, it'll probably be the south.
Right.
Which it was, Mississippi.
Right.
But the dishes that we did, Massachusetts, right, Rhode Island, it was great.
This is one of them that went to the competition that he brought down there to Louisiana. We are going to put it together in just a little. We have halibut. We're going to get that going, right,
yep,
for the recipe.
So here we have our beautiful halibut steak.
Mm-hmm.
Again, you can find this anywhere at any store. It's pretty common out here in Rhode Island.
Right.
The recipe is sustainable. Ask for Pacific halibut, not Atlantic.
That's what we're looking for.
That's what we're looking for.
All right.
So you want to dredge that in your Parmesan and curry crust, so you push that down nice and gently.
Just so it makes contact,
so it makes contact,
to it.
And so it has a nice little stick.
Right.
And we put in our pan, a dry pan, no oil.
Oh, really?
Okay, yeah. So what you actually want to melt that cheese, and what that cheese does is it creates a crust on your halibut.
Okay.
So dry pan, very low heat, and you just want to gently melt the Parmesan cheese. We season the top portion,
put that
with
on
a little
there.
Salt. And a little white pepper.
And just so everybody knows, this was the recipe the governor asked you to go down to New Orleans.
Yes.
To be part of the competition down there and to represent the state of Rhode Island. And
correct,
this was the recipe that you chose to bring down.
Besides the fish, we actually used pollock, which is, again, pollock, a lot of people don't know about pollock. Fish fingers, pollock.
Oh, okay.
So people, but to me, that was a very sustainable fish to use. But I substituted that with the halibut for Rhode Island.
For Rhode Island.
Here, you can find that anywhere.
Okay.
Pollock, it's difficult to find.
And this alone, this Parmesan with probably
intense flavor.
Really intense flavor, and probably would taste good not only on fish itself, but with anything.
With anything. And that's why back home in Pakistan, we have a thing called aloo gobi. And aloo gobi means potatoes and cauliflower with curry. So that was my take on this dish.
Okay.
So in this dish, we have our potatoes.
Mm-hmm.
Again, it's a little French cuisine, but we're doing, remember I had the theme about the past, the present, and the future of cuisine, how they all can work together. The past is basically sauteing and frying the squid and the halibut and the sauce bordelaise.
Mm-hmm.
The present is sous vide cooking, which is basically our potatoes that are put in a sous vide bag. It's a sous vide bag with duck fat, lemon juice and rosemary. We cook it at a precise temperature.
And something else that probably has an intense flavor to it, too.
It has intense because all the flavors stay in the bag.
Okay.
So basically when you open the bag up, you can smell the aroma of rosemary. So that's the present. And the future, obviously, is our bone marrow powder.
And some of the bone.
Yeah, maltodextrin with it.
And you'll put that on there. Okay.
Yeah.
One more segment to go, and we are going to show you what the final dish looks like that he was sent to New Orleans to represent the state of Rhode Island. We're going to put that all together. Back to you. Newport, who have brought him in today. We have the halibut, and we want to show everybody how it encrusted itself.
Yeah, here's the crust. So basically, the Parmesan and the curry have actually made a nice crust on top of the halibut. That goes in the oven for between 2 to 3 minutes, depending on the thickness.
Okay, so we're going to throw that in now?
Sure, you want to go ahead?
What temperature is our oven set to?
I set it on 475.
Okay.
Yeah, so nice high heat. You want to get it quickly done, quickly out.
And
so
take
it doesn't
it
dry out too much.
Got it.
If you wanted to start off, would you like to take out the confit potatoes?
Sure.
Now, the fingerling potatoes have been confit in duck fat, rosemary, lemon juice, and salt.
Okay.
And what are these? How are you cooking them?
It's called a sous vide machine, and what it is, I love this machine because it's like an employee. It doesn't complain. It shows up on time and it cooks precisely, and it always comes out perfect. So that's what I love about it.
Employee of the month.
No
right
vacations,
there.
No health vacation, benefits. Yeah. It's all good.
You leave it on 24 hours, you come back, it's still there. So, but that's one of the best things to have in the kitchen because it's precise cooking. So for potatoes, 85 degrees for 35 minutes, they come off fantastic.
And you know that they're
going to
be
I can use a knife to open that up for you.
Okay.
And if you want to just pour those in the bag, in the bowl, and just toss a little salt on them.
A little bit
and
of salt.
And now here what we can do.
Now what are we going to do?
We have a little, you want to do this?
Sure.
A little cauliflower.
Okay. And you cut these.
Yeah,
on a mandolin. I don't know if we can see how paper thin. They are so very thin. Do you want to put them all in here?
Yeah, go ahead. Put them all in there.
Dump all in here. Okay.
And then we can put a little lemon juice, some parsley, and some salt.
All right. Okay. This.
Some good, aren't
I? Some parsley.
Yeah.
This looks like fresh parsley, too.
Fresh parsley. And this gives it a nice little mix. You want to use a spoon?
The flavors smell incredible. We've got the curry going.
Some salt. Yeah. Put that
in. There you go. Okay. So that's a quick pickle for cauliflower.
Duck that in here.
Okay.
Yeah. And did you add the salt?
I put some salt
in
there,
yes. And then we can start plating up.
Okay.
We have a bowl.
This smells good.
It's come out. So again, can you smell that rosemary?
Yes.
It's intense, and that's fun because of sous vide cooking, and it stays in the bag. So when you're cooking something on the stove, you can smell it.
Mm-hmm.
When you're cooking something in a bag, you can't smell it. Why? Because all the flavors are going into
the
product.
They're trapped in there.
Yeah, they're trapped in there. So they permeate into the potatoes.
Wow.
So there we have our potatoes.
Okay, so far so good.
You want to drop the broccoli into the hot
put
water.
Put this in here.
Again, salted water, always boiling.
Okay.
And about, say, a minute and a half to 2 minutes.
To let it go.
Yeah.
Right.
And now here's our bordelaise. Now, this is a very classic sauce. It's a red wine sauce. And I like using a Rhone wine. It's medium bodied and it has a nice flavor to it.
Okay. And this is something that you had prepared earlier.
Yes.
Correct?
This we have to. The recipe is online, but it's onions, black pepper, thyme, red wine. And
that sounds good too.
Viljou, yeah.
And it smells good. It's all these flavors combining in the kitchen right now.
And we were talking all of the flavors in this dish. Everything, it has its own unique flavor, but all of them are very strong.
Strong
flavors.
And they all come together at the end.
Right.
Once
that's
you try
the dish,
yes,
that's perfect. That's what you want.
Okay. What else you just put in?
You
just put
some edamame.
Okay.
I love edamame. Exactly. So out here, hot pan.
Mm-hmm.
You can see it. Now this is for squid. We're going to do caramelized squid.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Again, this squid's from Point Judith. Really hot pan. Smoke it 30 seconds, not longer.
Okay. Let's do it. Let's do it, Chef. Woo! There they go.
And at the same time, a little pepper.
Some fire.
And a little salt.
Wow. Okay. We got the flame, we got the smoke.
And you want that smoke. You want to caramelize them.
Okay.
Yeah.
They didn't have a chance, by the way.
No, sorry. Hey, you know, quick, look at Timmy. Turn the fan on there.
Yep. Chef is on.
Well, it's on your side. There we go.
Okay, that's done.
All right, we've just got a little time left. Very quickly, give everybody the address of your restaurant.
It's 382 Thames Street in Bristol, Rhode Island.
Okay.
And I'd like to give a special thanks to Discover Newport that sponsored us, Trace and Trust. We have Linda Arruda and Stephen Bridgety from Bristol that did relentless phone calls to back me up and give me all the support.
That's
that we
great.
Need.
Beautiful.
Louisiana.
And a big thanks to your employee that you brought along. They never complained.
Oh, yeah. Employee of the year there.
There we go.
All right. If you want the recipe so you can try and make this at home, we are going to post that up on our website. It's the Rhode Show page at WPRI.com.